Dr. Ganapathy has spoken, I really don't think we have anything to talk further. So he's covered the technology, he's covered the business model, he's covered the services, and I guess everything else. So it's good that we'll go into the question answer sessions. With that, I'm Anita Sheth. Let me just correct my spelling, because in all the books it's S-E-T-H. It's not S-E-T-H, it's S-H-E-T. I'm Anita Sheth. It's a year since we started Pinkwell Healthcare Services, and I'm one of the founding members of the organizations. We are into the online consultations, expert opinions, a complete online bracket of it, and moving towards the mHealth. So we kind of will be covering pretty much the gamut of what Dr. Ganapathy spoke about. But as you know, in contrast to what Dr. Ganapathy has spoken, we are babies. We are babies in this field. We are learning the things that we have discovered in the last year and a half, the tasks, the issues that we are going to face, and how we are going to go. I'm glad in the end he said that if you have a medical legal issue, please come over to me, and you bet it, I'm going to take his mobile number immediately after this. So thank you. That's me, and we can go on.
So my name is Nitin Mathur, and I run a company called HealthPA.com. HealthPA stands for Health Personal Assistant. And the core idea of our portal is to help people identify and connect to a suitable healthcare provider. The core concept is that, you know, through all the presentations we would have heard today, one thing is very clear, that over the last 5 to 7 years, healthcare as a subject has become much, much more complex than it was 5-7 years back, right? And not only in terms of, so, you know, 5-7 years back, if you fell sick in Delhi, there were two places you could go and get admitted. There was a AIMS, a Gangaram, and maybe an Apollo. And there also you had to probably call someone to get a room, you know. And that scenario has completely changed. So not only are there multiple provider options, there are also treatment options that exist today, and the overall complexity has gone up. So The space that we are trying to fill up at healthpa.com is that of a health counselor or a health advisor, with the idea being that, you know, if today you have an insurance advisor, a financial advisor, a real estate advisor, and so on and so forth, healthcare has finally become important and complex enough to merit an advisor for you in that space as well.
I'm from Girish from K Foundation, based in Hyderabad. This is the hospitals, K Hospitals Group arm of Foundation. We've been doing lots of healthcare work for the last 4 years in the rural market. And what have been spoken in the pre by Dr. Ganapathy also, we took the plan to action basically. So we started working on a pilot in a 50 villages program in Maharashtra, where we actually trained a health worker to use the handheld device. And also with the support of a remote doctor, they can actually start treating people at the village level itself. And the idea is that if they can treat 70% of the cases at the village level itself, you have majority of your disease burden being covered at that village. So the handheld device, it's already in place, and it meets most of the requirements of what the problems we have in terms of access, power, electricity. It overcomes all those things. And it also overcomes the language barriers. Basically, it's in a local language in Marathi, so they can do the whole thing. It doesn't take much time to train. And it has an inbuilt clinical decision support system for primary care. So if you come for cold, fever, cough, backache, headache, or anything, within 4 steps, that is with 4 questions, they can actually come out with an end of pathway with a prescription. This will tell you either you could be treated at the village level, or you require a call center support at the back end. Now, we have a call center support in Nagpur Hospital, we have establishment. So within a period of 5 minutes, if you have a doctor visit within a 5 minutes, even through this system, you can get treated within 5 minutes itself. And you could be treated, and not only, a prescription will be generated through the device, which you can actually dispense then and there itself.
So I think, Girish, you have a lot to say. So after the introduction, probably we'll give 2 minutes
probably,
to...
Yeah, I'll go through that anyways. Thanks.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Vijaya Verma. I run a company called Yos Technologies, Yos meaning well-being in Sanskrit. And this is a 4-year-old company, and we are actually into electronic health records and smart health cards, and which we actually give to the patients either directly, which is, you know, through the online portal, or we also actually give it through the hospitals. So we actually have a record management software which we actually sell to the hospitals, which connects to the PHR, to the personal health record of the patient. So in effect, we actually are using the patient's PHR and the smart card as a hub, and using that actually to create a connected ecosystem. We have started with hospitals, we are moving to labs, and as since this is also related to mobile, right from the beginning we made sure that our portal, we are mobile enabled, so many of the applications that you actually do online we can also do through the mobile. So in fact, you know, he was mentioning things like the doctor can, you can send immunization reminders. So we have an entire calendar for 12 years. The moment the baby is born, actually we have the full calendar, and it actually sends out SMS to the mother, so that, you know, they can come back to immunization at, you know, the precise times. So to some extent, yeah, some of the things which have been mentioned are already have been in place for the past year or so. Maybe as the panel discussion goes on, you know, I can elaborate more on what we've been doing. One of the major things is also using of the smart card for emergency care. I think the previous session was on emergency care. We actually have critical health information in the card, and which actually can be used at any hospital to instantly get, you know, your emergency information, so that you can get treatment during the golden hour. So maybe I'll pass it on to Ruchi so that she can carry on from here.
Sure. I think this is a very good example of assisted living here. I have been to Apollo corporate IT department, and to be very frank, when I talk about PHR to them, and when a patient comes in and he says that, okay, I'm done with Apollo, I'm getting shifted to probably Mumbai where there is no Apollo, I'll get it, get my treatment ahead from here, probably in one of the Fortis establishments. Apollo hospitals are very... I will not quote Apollo hospitals. I will say any hospital is very scared, or I don't know, afraid to share the records, because to their understanding, sharing the records is giving away your potential customer away. So I think people like Yoast Technologies or inventions like these actually help people understand it from a third-party perspective, where they are an interface and there are thousands of hospitals which can host their records there, and there could be continuous sharing. Then only the, everybody will agree with me, then only the name PHR or EHR stands for. Till the time there is no sharing, it will be like a photo gallery, which you are saying that it is visible only to me or to my friends in a Facebook kind of a setup. So I think that's a very good example of electronic medical records. And yes, emergency care, as we talk about smart card. Mr. Nandan Nilankari, to quote here, I think he's been the person who's talking about unique identification number. And we were having a discussion in Delhi when I was attending the Global Government Transformation Forum, and I got to know that there were plans to, revolve around. There's some echo in the mic. There were certain plans to evolve around that. IRDA was actually taking expert advice from people like us as to how can we module the guidelines in such a way that they become healthcare friendly, as per se. And we were talking about, I am a person, I today don't have a ration card in my hand. Probably I have a PAN card, but I don't have a voter's identity card. I might have a passport, but I might be not having. So when these things are not interfaceable or interoperable, how can we talk about unique identification number at this point in time? But yes, smart card, if we talk about that this person is suffering from this ailment, has an allergy to this kind of a drug, and is admitted in this hospital, has a prime insurance number by Apollo Munich, or something of that sort, it actually helps a lot, because tomorrow if I am actually, God forbid, meeting an accident, probably by driving bike from here, I know that there will be somebody who will probably snap out that card, would probably swipe it, and probably know that what I am suffering from. It was echoing earlier, so probably technology again. So I would say that what we are taking into consideration today are a lot of things, EMR, PHR, right information, health.com sites, WAP-enabled, mobile browsable sites. We are talking about tools, reminders, diet charts, several other things. And as Professor Ganpati rightly said, that we are moving from illness to wellness. Because illness is something which you already have, you will probably go for rejuvenation or rehabilitation. But wellness is something where you can actually catch the disease young before actually you get admitted in a hospital or probably go in a medication kind of stuff. So I think we'll take forward from here. I would request questions coming in. Anybody who has questions, who is probably planning a startup like this, or who want to learn from the experiences, bottlenecks, hiccups which people faced when they actually started something of this sort, most welcome. Any questions? Over to the audience. No questions.
What has the patient take-up been like? What has the consumer reaction been to, like, think about healthcare, etc.? Do they have a lot of interest, or is it really you have to push the product?